right? So the energy is a little low. Can we do something with the energy?
You're working over here? Most of you. Is there anyone over here who doesn't work at an office? Obviously there's work to do, but is there someone over here who doesn't work at office? Any hands? Awesome. So you work in college?
Yeah.
Yeah, you go to college. You're studying. Awesome. So at work or at home, when we are working from morning to evening, there are times when our energies dip. Yes or no? Do we identify that, okay, my energy is down now? Yes? So I would like you guys to pair up, two people. Okay? Two people, just pair up. Turn to each other and talk about a time in your day when your energy level goes down and how you respond to people when your energy levels go down. So when you're at work or at home, you come back after a tired day from college or from your workplace, how do you deal with low energy? Do you identify that, oh, you're feeling low on energy, and what do you do about it? So once both of you have shared, turn to each other, give a big high five. Give a big high five, like, yeah. And say, thank you. Thank you. You can sit down. Anyone wants to share what happens when your energy level goes down? How are your interactions with the world? How is your interaction with your own self? What happens? Anyone wants to share? Yeah, go ahead.
Our energy levels is people. So we draw our energies, we are like the power socket, the power comes in when we have people around us. So we are responsible for energy dip, people are responsible for the energy boost.
anyone else wants to share?
So we are opposite people. I told you that I'm never out of energy, so I don't have to do much about it anyway. And if I'm out of energy, it's in the night and I sleep.
You sleep.
That's it.
Awesome.
So, and she says that because she travels a lot to work, she feels really tired because of that. And when she's really tired, she's like, please leave me alone.
Please leave me alone.
Give me 5 minutes. I'll bounce back.
Okay.
I love to exercise. So when I don't exercise, I have these photos of mountains in my room. I look at them and I'm like, haan, jaana hai. So I get up and I go.
Awesome. Give her a big round of applause, guys. So, what is being relevant mean to you? What does it mean to be relevant? We think of being relevant at work, but as human beings, as we are evolving, as we are aging, as we are growing so beautifully, what does relevance mean to you?
When you're relevant despite not trying to be relevant, I think that's when I have achieved relevance.
That's a good one. When I'm relevant despite not trying to be relevant, that's when I have achieved relevance. Am I right? Yeah, that's a good one. Give her a big round of applause. Anyone else? What does relevant to your own self mean? We are born, right, with this body. Yes? What is being relevant to this body mean? Who am I answerable? Am I answerable to my parents? Am I answerable to the society around? Or am I answerable to the kids? Is this what a woman is all about? I'm answerable to myself. But what has happened throughout the years, we have been conditioned. Yes or no? What is the conditioning that a woman undergoes right from her childhood?
Homemaker
or would-be homemaker. And no one understands why they want to educate a homemaker all her life. You know, 25 to 28 years, they teach her, they put her in school, in best of the best institutes, and they expect a woman to be a homemaker.
There was nothing else in life.
But do you know the stark reality right now in India? We are from bottom, the fifth nation across the world. Only 17% of women are in the workforce. Rest of them are at home only because they got married or they're having kids. Why? It's because of conditioning. Similarly, a lot of us are going to workforce, and most of you in this room are coming to work, there's a certain amount of conditioning which has happened to us right from our childhood. Yes or no? What is this conditioning all about? What is the conditioning? No matter you go work from morning to evening, you have to go back home and take care of your child and the house, and all the responsibilities will fall on your head. No matter how successful you are. How many of you agree with that? All of us. So, what are we going to do about it now? Do you think we are relevant to this time? Do you think as women, we are relevant to this current generation? Don't you think that conditioning belonged to a generation where women were at home doing most of the chores at home? But now, though we are going out and working for long hours, still the entire responsibility of it falls on the mother or the woman at home. How many of you agree with that? I'm glad all of you are agreeing. So what are we going to do about it?
Call the men in for the session.
Men, yes. Exactly, you are absolutely right. So, what is being relevant to me right now? I would share a story of one of my very good client. She is 45 years old. She manages an account of more than 40 crores. Okay? She manages her kit, she manages her home, she manages the accounts of a lot of clients. She manages a portfolio of 40 crores. She was having low anemia. You know anemia? What is anemia? The hemoglobin levels were low. Other than that, there was absolutely no other problem. Her hemoglobin levels were low. She went for a regular checkup. The doctor said, go ahead, go for a, take some medication. She was like, let me postpone. Finally, it came to 4. She's having shivering. She's not able to sit. She's not able to focus. She's not able to manage life actions. So she goes into the hospital to get a treatment done because ek do din mein ho jayega, I'll get admitted. I'll get blood into this. I don't have to take tablets regularly. And I'll get back to normalcy immediately. And she goes into the hospital. And next, she opens her eyes in ICU. And she manages 40 crores account. And by the time she steps out of the ICU, there is the account which she was managing, it fell down to -40%. -40%. 40 crore account has gone into -40% by the time she comes out of the hospital. And from 8 months, 22 years, she's one of the top in her fields. And today, she's in debt. People are hounding at her door to just get their money back. Overnight, it has happened. Why? Did she have any major illness? Did she have anything which is, life-threatening? No. It was a very, very simple thing like, low energy levels. Low energy levels, she's feeling tired, exhausted, but she's thinking, no, it's okay, I'm working hard. This is normal. And pushing it under the carpet. And it was just simple anemia. She developed a reaction to the blood that they had given. And that put her into a danger zone. And that's how, she's gone into -40%. All of you have mobile phones? Yes, can you lift up the mobile phone? Okay, show your mobile phone. When did you update that mobile phone last? When did you do the last update on the mobile phone? When did you change that phone? 1 year back you changed the phone? Yes. When did you charge that phone? Every day. When do you delete from that phone? When that system says, I can't take it anymore. Right? Imagine that mobile phone as you. You need charging every single day. As humans. And when that mobile phone gets overburdened, what happens? You need to delete certain things. And you know how to delete that certain things? It's very, very simple, which is free of cost and available everywhere. That is just to breathe right. And that helps, that starts deep breathing over a period of time will start deleting those memories which are hurting. As women, we have this hormone called as estrogen, which controls cortisol, which makes us remember every damn thing that a person said. Even in the smallest negative thing that someone says, we'll remember it for years together. Yes or no? Yes. Do you still remember people, that person hurt me then? Whereas the positive ones don't get registered so fast. As women, we have a lot more stresses. We take a lot more burden than what our men do. And how do you eliminate all of that? It's through workout. Workout is something which helps keep the cortisol levels in check. Every single day you go for a workout. Simple thing like just walking for 20 minutes. You don't need to do any high intensity stuff. Just in the entire week, if you can manage 150 minutes of time, then that can have a control on the cortisol levels so that you can handle life much more beautifully. So how many of you work out here? So something which is free, we don't do it, no? Something which you just have to go out, breathe air and walk. That's it, right? Is there anything needed to go for a walk? And that has the capacity to keep in control most of the lifestyle diseases which we are having right now, which are the cause of the, it is the number one leading cause of deaths across the world. What is that? Lifestyle diseases. That is the stress, the food that we eat that is putting us into a situation like that. Okay? So, what are you going to do today? Whole day you're hearing about all the good stuff that these amazing speakers out here are talking. How many of you are ready to take action? You already did? That's for today. What about tomorrow? So repeat that tomorrow and day after and after. Are you going to pledge that at least to the next person? Yes? So put your hand on your heart and say, I am going to stay relevant by doing what? By doing what? By just going for a walk for at least 20 minutes. Yes? And breathing well for 10 minutes. That's it. Doable? Are you all with me? I want to hear it loud. Yes. Thank you so much. This is Dr.Mani Pavitra.
The 21 Days Challenge. Log into www.millionmoms.in. For more details, contact 77024-9110.